in the last lecture, we understood what was a, we defined what was a random variable. So, now we are going to look at, and towards the end of last lecture, we defined what was a discrete and continuous random variable. So, we will spend some time to understand more about what is a discrete and continuous random variable. So, these were the definitions which we gave in the last session, which was we defined a discrete random variable as a random variable that can take on at most a countable number of possible values. Whereas we said a continuous random variable is it cannot be counted or it is infinitely divisible. Now, let's understand what is a discrete random variable and a continuous random variable through an example. So, instead of going and understanding a definition, I can also say a discrete random variable is a random variable that can take possible values that are discrete points. I am again emphasizing that are discrete points. So, if I have my real number line here, so I have a 0 here, I have a 1 here, I have a 2 here, it could take a minus 1, it could take a minus 2. So, these are isolated discrete points along the real number line. I repeat, a discrete random variable is a random variable that can take possible values along a real number line that are discrete points. The key idea is they are discrete points. So, typically when we talk about discrete random variables, you involve the operation of counting number of heads. You are counting. Whereas, a continuous random variable is the random variable that has possible values. So, if I again go back to my real number line, it will not take, so I have, it will not take isolated discrete values, but it would take values that might form an interval along the real number line. Can it be this interval? It could be. It could be minus 3 to plus 4. It could be. But it takes the values in an interval. A more rigorous definition of what is a continuous random variable would be offered in advanced courses. But at this point of time, you need to understand a discrete random variable will take discrete points along a real number line, whereas a continuous random variable would take values in an interval along a real number line. So, typically a continuous random variable would involve a measurement of something, whereas a discrete random variable involves a counting. So, now let's motivate and understand this through an example. Let's look at an apartment complex. So, what is this apartment complex? An apartment complex, there are 4 floors in an apartment complex. Each floor has 3 apartments. So, if I am looking at this apartment complex, each floor has 3 apartments. So, it has a 1-bedroom apartment, a 2-bedroom apartment and 3-bedroom apartment. So, there are totally 12 apartments. There are 4 floors. There are 3 houses per floor. And in these 3 houses or 3 apartments, first is a 1-bedroom, I have a 2-bedroom and a 3-bedroom apartment. This is how this apartment complex has been structured. So, let's look at the data which is summarized in the following table. So, if you look at the data, I have 12 apartments that is given by the cases 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. These are my 12 apartments. So, you see the first 3 apartments are in the first floor, 4, 5, 6 are in second floor, 7, 8, 9 are in third floor, and 10, 11, 12 are in fourth floor. When you look at the number of bedrooms, the first apartment, fourth apartment, 7th and 10th have one bedroom each. The second, 5th, 8th and 11th have two bedrooms each. Whereas the 3rd, 6th, 9th and 12th have three bedrooms each. So, this is the data I have collected. Now, even though typically you might expect the sizes of apartments to be the same, but there is some error and I am computing the sizes of the apartment correct to 2 decimal points in square feet. So, the first apartment is 900.23 square feet, the fourth is 900.48, the seventh is 900.53 square feet. So, all the measurement of the sizes of the apartment in square feet for each of the apartment is given. In addition, we also are capturing how many meters from the lift is each one of the apartment. This is just fictitious data. This is just data from an apartment complex, and we are capturing it in this following way. Now, I can look at this as a random experiment. Now, what is the random experiment in this case? Now, let me define the random experiment as I am randomly selecting an apartment from these 12 apartments. I am selecting one apartment from these 12 apartments. So, the sample space of my random experiment is any one of the 12 apartments. So, the outcome is I could either have selected the first or the second or the third, so forth up to the 12th. So, this constitutes the sample space of my experiment. The outcomes is 1, 1 represents the first apartment, 2 represents second, third and so forth, 12 represents the 12th apartment. Now, recall when we talked about a random variable, we said that a random variable associates some quantity with every outcome of the sample space. Now, suppose I am asking the following questions. Let a random variable be the number of bedrooms. So, let's go back to our data. I can see that the random variable that is associated with my first outcome is 1. The random variable that is associated with the second is 2. Third is 3. Okay. Fourth is again 1. Fifth is 2. So, if I am looking at random variable associated with each outcome, I have a 1, 2, 3, a 1, 2, 3, a 1, 2, 3, a 1, 2, 3. These are the random variables. Where what is the random variable? The random variable X is the number of bedrooms in the apartment. And I see that this random variable, every outcome of my sample space has a random variable or a quantity associated with it. What are the possible values this random variable can take now? It can take the possible values the random variable can take are 1, 2 and 3. Okay. So, you can see that the possible values the random variable can take are 1, 2 and 3. Now, let's go to the second question. The second question says that let the random variable be the floor number of the apartment. Now, again, let's go back to our data. The first, with the first apartment, I know that the floor number associated with my first number is 1, with the second apartment is 1, third is 1. So, in terms of my sample space, when I come back here and I am defining say y to be the number of the floor or the floor number with 1 I'm associating variable 1, with 2 again 1, with 3 again 1, 4 it is a 2, 5 it is a 2, 6 is a 2, 7 is a 3, 8 is a 3, 9 is a 3, 10 is a 4, 11 is a 4, and 12 is a 4. So, the possible values, the random variable which is the floor number, every outcome is associated with a quantity. The possible values this random variable can take are 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay. So, now you can see that the possible values this random variable can take are 1, 2, 3, and 4. Now, let me define the random variable to be the size of the apartment. Earlier, we looked at number of bedrooms, then we looked at the floor number. Now, I'm looking at the size of the apartment. Again, let's go back. Now, when we go back to the data and look at the size of the apartment, we don't see that it can be mapped to discrete points on the real number line, whereas here I could have, so in the first case, I could map it to 1, 2 and 3. These are discrete isolated points. In the second case, it is 1, 2, 3, 4. Whereas in the third case, when I talk about a real number line, I see that I can have that the data can take any value between 900 square feet to say 1780 or 1800 square feet. So, in a sense, I can give the values, the possible values, the size of the apartment can take, the possible value, the size can be in an interval, and this interval is 900 to 1800 square feet. Now, let's define the fourth random variable to be the distance of the apartment from the lift. Again, we go back to our data. When we go back to our data, we see that again here there are not discrete points, but it's again a continuum. And when you look at a continuum, I can again write that the distance of the apartment from the field. So, here if I define this random variable in the earlier case, the size to be some z, I know that this random variable z would belong to 900 to 1800 square feet. Now, I could call this say z1. And I know that this belongs to 324 to 505 meters. So, we have seen the example of a random variable here which takes values 1, 2, 3. Here it takes the values 1, 2, 3, 4. Here it belongs to a interval, and in the last case it also belongs to a interval. So, going back to the definition which we proposed, instead of definition, the understanding which we proposed for a random variable, the discrete and continuous. We said a discrete random variable typically would take discrete points along the real number line, and here it forms an interval. I can now classify the four random variables which we have given as examples here as the first two, that is the discrete random variables in the data, are nothing but the number of bedrooms and floor number, whereas the continuous random variables in my example data set, the apartment data set, are size of the apartment and distance of the apartment to the lift. So, let's look at a few more examples where we naturally come across discrete random variables. Again, remember, discrete random variables involves counting. So whenever you are having instances where, for example, you count the number of people in a household or number of languages a person can speak, number of times a person takes a particular test before qualifying or before passing, number of accidents that happen in an intersection, number of spelling mistakes in a report, all these are count. You can see that everything represents the operation of counting. You can discuss or you can think of this as a discrete random variable. Whereas the instances where I'm computing or measuring the temperature of a person, measuring the height of a person, measuring the speed of a vehicle, or measuring the time taken by a person to write an exam, time taken by a person to reach office, all these instances which involve the measure of a quantity, I can think of the variable or the random variable that is involved as a continuous random variable. So, in summary, what we have learned in this section was, we first defined formally what was a discrete random variable and a continuous random variable. A discrete random variable takes countable values and it can be mapped on to discrete points on a real number line, whereas a continuous variable, it actually can be mapped on to an interval on a real number line. For now, we are going to focus on discrete random variables.